What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating ZFS RAIDZ pool, right? Or like a data store within our Proxmox lab. So let's get right into it. All right, so I have been sitting on this video idea for the longest. I have a bunch of other things that I did within my Proxmox lab. I just haven't had the time to actually push out these videos. So today, when we set up our Proxmox lab, I captured everything. So today, we're going to go over how I created a ZFS RAIDZ pool in Proxmox. It's pretty simple. So first thing that we need to do is load up our Proxmox portal, and it's going to want you to log in. So enter your username, your password, and just click on login. It's going to log you in. Excellent. So from here, right, the data center, which is called BTNHD, on the middle section, we're going to go into disk. And within disk, we're going to click on ZFS. Click on it. Yes. Boom. Now you have a big button right there that says create ZFS. So I clicked on it, get this nice little wizard kind of menu kind of thing. And all you have to do is just enter a name. And I selected all my disk, which is actually 1.60 terabytes. And for the RAID level, that's a dropdown. By default, it is a single disk, but we are going to click on that dropdown menu and we're going to select, you guessed it, RAIDZ, because that's what the title of this video is all about. And compression is set to on, and I think that's a shift, if I could see, because I'm blind as a bat. 12, you are able to increase it. Again, I'm not a guru dealing with Proxmox, so when I started setting this all up, it was all new to me. You guys probably said to yourself, why are you using ZFS? I don't know. I read an article somewhere that this is the best type of format to use with Proxmox. You probably have something else in mind. If so, let me know what type of data store or type of format that you created within your lab. But for me, I've been using ZFS with no problem. There's no lag and it's been running sweetness. So from here, we are going to click on create and done. It's already created. There goes our data store. And you are able to click on details and everything is online and just click on that little blue X on the upper right hand side and close it. That's it. The size of my data store is around 4.79 terabytes. That's with all three of them. That's pretty huge. You know, I was happy with that size and I'm able to create multiple virtual machines with no problem. And I only had three disks to create this. If I had additional, I could probably, I think I was able to do like a RAID 5 or something like that. But that's it. That is how we create a ZFS within Proxmox Lab. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.